What's your favorite way to listen to music? For me, the easiest way is to listen on my phone. I grab a pair of headphones, I choose my favorite song, and I'm rocking and rolling. But this might be the easiest way I can listen to music, but it's certainly not my favorite. My favorite way of listening to music is by playing a record.
A record player! Oh, I haven't seen one of these in ages. Okay now, slow.
A record is a big circle that has sound recorded onto it. There are little grooves in this material that hold sound. And when you touch a stylus, which is a special type of needle, to the grooves and hook it up to speakers, you can hear music. Way before phones and computers were even around, a record is the way that we saved sound to listen back to. Before records, you had to go and buy the actual paper copy of the music you'd want to play. You'd have to go home and learn how to play it on an instrument, and that was a lot of work. Or you'd have to have the money to go and see a live concert to hear your favorite song. So records were a big turning point in listening to music because it didn't require special musical skill like knowing how to play an instrument or read music notation. So let's take a look at how records have transformed how we listen to music. We have to thank Thomas Edison, you know, that light bulb guy, for inventing something called the phonograph, which was a very early style of a record player. Before he invented the light bulb, Edison came up with this idea to record and playback sound on wax cylinders. And it's said that the first song ever to be recorded and played on a phonograph was a recording of Mary Had a Little Lamb. You can see in these examples of wax cylinders that I have that it's about the size of a toilet paper roll, and the grooves that have the recordings of the sound go along the curve of the tube. If we jump ahead about 10 years after Edison invents the phonograph, we find ourselves with a German inventor named Emil Berliner, who's credited with inventing the flat disc style records that we used today. Way back in 1877, he came up with the design to record and playback sound on record discs on a device called a gramophone. The gramophone is another type of early record player, and every year the modern music industry celebrates what's called the Grammy Awards, which get their name from this early piece of music technology. Down in my basement, I happen to have something similar to a gramophone called a graphinola. It still works, so let me show you how it plays a record. You turn the crank. There's no power. You don't plug it in. The special gears and windings spin the record, and when you drop the needle onto the record, sound comes out of what's called a reproducer. As the needle travels through the grooves of the record, picking up the vibrations travel through the reproducer and through the tone arm and down to the speaker section of the graphinola, allowing you to hear the music. In fact, the music we're listening to right now is by Enrico Caruso, and many people played his records on gramophones. He was considered one of the first musical superstars of the recording era. By 1917, the Victor Talking Machine Company, located in Camden, New Jersey, released the first jazz record by the original Dixieland Jazz Band. And by 1940, Walt Disney changes the record industry forever by releasing their soundtrack for Fantasia, which showcased new recording techniques that would help usher in the rock and roll era. By the 1950s, and with millions of dollars in the record-making business, kids everywhere flocked to their local record stores to get their hands on the most popular song of the week. And with the invasion of the Beatles in 1964, rock and roll and the business of selling music was cemented in American culture for years to come. One thing that would change, though, was the desire to have music that was portable. Records were big and heavy and not convenient to travel with. So as sizes changed and technology got better and better, we saw new ways of listening to music come on the scene. An early competitor to the vinyl record was the cassette tape, which were small, lightweight, and could be played in a car or on a Walkman with headphones. And ushering in the digital music age, CDs became the primary source of listening through the 1990s and early 2000s, with their ability not only to play on a CD player, but also to be shared on a computer or iPod. But all this time, records were still there, some collecting dust, some used for listening, and others used by DJs in hip-hop and dance music. And even today, both new and old artists are releasing their music both digitally and on vinyl records. And in recent years, vinyl has outsold CDs as the primary way of listening to music, with over $224 million worth of records sold in the first half of 2019 alone.
Most likely your parents or grandparents had records that they listened to when they were kids. You should ask them what their favorite record was, and maybe they still have it. You might have records around your house like I do that you listen to for fun. And if you don't, there are a ton of music stores in our area that sell records. And a record store is one of my favorite places to go because the experts that work there can guide you in discovering new music that you might like.
So this week, in addition to the songs that we're working on playing, I'd like to know what your favorite way of listening to music is. Do you listen on YouTube, or do you use Spotify or Apple Music? Do you listen to the radio or have a collection of CDs? Or do you have records at home that you like to put on and listen to? You should also talk to mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, and Uncle Cat, Dog, Bird about their favorite music to listen to, and you might just discover your new favorite band. Have a great week, and we'll see you in the next one.